Here at the Theatre of Dreams on not a very nice day at all, but we are joined with two of the football greatest pundits ever, Mark Lawrence and Alan Hansen. What are you doing down here at Old Trafford, guys?
Thanks for that intro. That's lovely.
Thanks, anytime.
Basically, we are reminiscing about the 1980s. Absolutely fabulous period in soccer.
Well, that surprises me, really. Anything at all, any major memories from the 80s, if we're going down there?
Oh, well, you know, there was one time, Darren, I remember coming down. I think we beat United that day. I don't like to bring it up in the 80s, but we were a good start.
Red meant a different colour in those days, let me tell you.
Yes, and red dye meant something else as well. It wasn't just splashes of the camera, let me tell you. And I remember taking the ball off Ralph Milne. He was a big tackler.
Really?
Big tackle, yes. Wide. But I had him in my pocket all day, after the game, that was.
That was a little one. He was very spot here. Maldoni tackled him, never saw it coming. For me, no hesitation. I mean, the 80s are fabulous time that they were.
All right. You know, yeah.
I'm going to attempt to bring you up to the 90s now. I mean, the 1990s. Just anything, guys, anything.
Oh.
90s?
You had that holiday that time.
Oh, I went to Benidorm, 94. It was lovely, it were. Didn't watch any football. I wasn't interested in this.
And I, for one, bought a Granada. Fabulous car.
Right, okay. You're supposed to mention other channels, and is it MUTV?
No, that's all right. No memories at all from the 90s. I mean, is this anything to do with Liverpool's sort of sudden demise, really?
Well, we dominated in the 80s, didn't we? You know, and I was a real tough sort of defender, and Alan here, you know, he was quite good as well.
You said
you've done
a bit of domination in your time after
pitch. That's right, yes, I do.
Basically, I don't think we're going to get out of the 80s here at all. I've attempted, I'm very sorry, but I'm going to have to put it back to studio.
Coming up to me and saying, "Oh, haven't you got..."